Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Do you like to watch car racing? Or maybe your favorite video game puts you in the driver's seat of a race car. Either way, this sport is all about speed and velocity, which is our topic for today. So let's buckle up and get to it. But before we get started around the track, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to compare speed and velocity, compare average versus instantaneous speed, and use appropriate units for speed and velocity. Did you know that a Formula One race car can reach speeds of over 200 miles per hour? I'm pretty sure most of us would get a speeding ticket if we tried to match that. But what does speed have to do with velocity? A commonly held misconception is that they really mean the same thing, velocity simply being the more scientific term. But it turns out that speed and velocity actually have slightly different meanings, and both are useful in science. Do you remember in the last lesson when we learned about the difference between distance and displacement? That difference is going to matter here. Speed is a way of measuring how much distance is covered in a given amount of time, while velocity tells us how much displacement occurred in a given amount of time. To calculate speed or velocity, we simply divide the distance or displacement by time. Notice that time is the only variable that these two measurements have in common. Does it really matter if we calculate speed versus velocity? Sometimes. Wouldn't they just be the same thing anyway? Well, sure. Sometimes it won't matter. And I'll clue you in on a secret. Even scientists get a little lazy sometimes and use the words interchangeably. But there will be times when it matters. For example, on some race car tracks, the starting line and finish line are in the same place. So if we were to measure the car's displacement at the moment it crossed the finish line, what would it be? Zero, because the car is right back where it started. Well, this makes our velocity zero as well. Not very impressive if you are the driver. But the track may have been a mile long, which means that each lap added 1 mile of distance that our car traveled. After 10 laps, the car has traveled a distance of 10 miles or 16 kilometers. That's going to lead to a much higher value for speed than velocity. Let's see how these numbers work out for speed and velocity. If after 4.5 minutes our car has completed 16 kilometers, it has a speed of 134 miles per hour. But if it is currently back on the position of the track where it started, its displacement, and therefore velocity, is zero. So in this case, speed is a much better measure of what motion is actually occurring. If velocity can mislead us in this way, is there ever a case when we would use it instead of speed? Well, you can probably guess that scientists wouldn't have come up with a way to calculate velocity if it wasn't ever useful. Let's imagine another scenario of a ski racer coming down a steep slope. What matters here is how quickly the skier gets from the top of the slope to the bottom. This is the displacement, not the distance. So we would want to calculate velocity instead of speed. The actual distance they travel will be greater because they don't ski in a straight line, but often traverse back and forth to pass between required markers. Their speed would take into account this increased distance and make it appear that they came down the hill faster than they actually did. So velocity will be a more useful measurement here, as it will be in many cases that we study. One other difference you may notice with speed and velocity is that velocity always includes a direction, while speed does not. Sometimes this direction will be obvious, such as 15 miles per hour north. Other times, you may not see a direction indicated with words. In this case, the sign of the value can be used to infer direction. Positive velocity values are assumed to be in the forward or up direction, while negative values indicate motion that is backwards or down. Because speed does not include direction, these values are always listed as positive. While they mean slightly different things, just like distance and displacement, speed and velocity make use of the same units. And just like we said in our previous lesson, when measuring position, it is important to always use an appropriate unit. The units used for speed and velocity are compound units. This means they combine units for two different measurements. What are some units for speed that you are familiar with? You might know of at least one unit for speed if you pay attention to speed limit signs while riding in the car, or if you have ever run on a treadmill. Pause the video for a moment and write down at least one unit that you can think of for speed. Then challenge yourself to see if you can come up with one more. Did you think of at least one? Miles per hour, or MPH, is a common unit for speed used in the US. What about countries that use the metric system? What unit would likely be substituted for miles? Kilometers. So kilometers per hour is one possible metric unit for speed and velocity. You might be surprised to learn, however, that kilometers per hour is not the standard metric unit for speed and velocity. Remember, we said that the units for speed are compound. They are made of two simpler units. Thinking about the two examples we've looked at already, miles per hour and kilometers per hour, what two types of units make up a unit for speed? Miles and kilometers are both units of distance, while hours is a unit of time. So speed units always have one unit for distance and one unit for time. This will help us figure out the standard metric unit for speed, or velocity. What is the standard metric unit for distance? You may have just thought meter, and you would be right. What about time? You might guess that it's hours or maybe minutes, but it's actually seconds. So what must be the standard unit for speed? Meters per second, often abbreviated M/S. It's good to note that when you see a slash in a unit, you can read it as per. You're probably not used to measuring speed in meters per second, so just to give you an idea, imagine spreading your arms out wide and rolling a ball such that it crosses the distance in 1 second. That's a speed of 1 meter per second, because it covers a distance of 1 meter in 1 second. If you are more comfortable thinking about speeds in miles per hour, 1 meter per second is just over 2 miles per hour, which is an easy walking pace for many people. To get a very rough estimate of what a meters per second speed would be in miles per hour, you can double the meters per second speed, but know that this estimate will be slightly low. To get a better conversion, multiply the meters per second speed by 2.2. The last thing we need to consider for speed and velocity is how it might change as an object is moving. For an example, let's go back a few years to the 2016 Grand Prix race in Mexico City. Finnish driver Valtteri Bottas set a new world record for the fastest Formula One speed ever recorded at 373 kilometers per hour. You might be a little disappointed then to learn that he only placed 8th after that amazing achievement. How is that possible? He broke a world record and didn't even win the race? It has to do with average speed versus instantaneous speed. As a racer flies around a track, they don't go at a constant speed the whole time. Where do you think they drive the fastest? On the straightaways. Then they have to slow down every time they come to a curve to avoid sliding off the road. At one particular moment in the race, during a straightaway, Bottas reached a speed of 373 kilometers per hour. That was an instantaneous speed at a particular moment in the race, but he would have gone much more slowly around the curves. To get his average speed, we would take the distance of the race, 4.3 kilometers, and divide by the total time it took him to complete the race, 1 minute and 19 seconds. After converting the time to hours, we get an average speed of just 196 kilometers per hour. This average speed is what determined his humble 8th place race finish, but his highest instantaneous speed put him in the record book. As we went through the lesson today, we looked at the difference between speed and velocity. Remember that velocity uses displacement, while speed uses distance. Both of these measurements are calculated by dividing by time. To find the units of your speed, it's simply the unit for distance per the unit of time. And remember that a high instantaneous speed doesn't necessarily lead to a high average speed. Next time, we'll take an even closer look at changes in velocity by learning about acceleration. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. See you next time. Hey, hey.